Hey, it's me, Tiffany. Welcome to my channel where I share all things pregnancy and postpartum related. I am a certified birth and postpartum doula, so that means that I support women and their families on their journey from conception to postpartum. If you haven't had a chance yet, please check out my website at www.nurturedbytiff.com, where you can check out my doula services that I offer. You can check out my childbirth education courses, and you can also check out my merch. So today's story I'm going to share with you comes from a suburb. I'm from Memphis. It comes from a suburb called Germantown. It was a four-month-old little baby who lost their lives in there as an adult. I'm assuming the adult lived in the home with the child or had some type of affiliation with the child in some way, shape, form, or fashion. So I'm going to show you this little clip, and then we'll come back and talk about it.
Germantown man is looking at facing charges following the death of an infant.
Yeah, 22-year-old David Taylor has been charged with aggravated child abuse and aggravated child neglect. WREG Shay Arthur spent the day working to get more information into this arrest.
Tonight, there are questions following the death of a four-month-old child. Germantown police tell us they were called to this home off Pine Valley Lane regarding the death of an infant. Investigators tell us the child had injuries consistent with abuse and neglect.
It's very sad. It is horrific. It is an incredible loss for that child's future, obviously, you know, for the family and for the community at large.
Tonight, police have not made the details surrounding the child's death public. Those who live at the home told us no comment about the incident. 22-year-old David Taylor has been charged with aggravated child abuse and aggravated child neglect. But people we talked to who are familiar with the case told us they're shocked by the charges Taylor is facing and believe there's more to the story. And while this neighborhood is left in mourning at the loss of such a little life, Virginia Stallworth, executive director of the Memphis Child Advocacy Center, says it's crucial everyone does their part to protect children if they suspect something is off.
It is not only our moral responsibility, but it is our legal responsibility to report any suspicions of abuse or neglect. We adults have that responsibility. And so whether that's in your neighborhood or your house of worship, anywhere where you are around children, if you see something, you should say something and make that report.
Shay Arthur, WREG, News Channel 3.
Taylor is being held on a $500,000 bond.
So that was the story. And I think I may have talked about a few days ago how, you know, it seems like this is happening more and more in our community where there are little babies, small children who are defenseless, who can't, some of them can barely even talk. Some of them, you know, cannot defend themselves. They can't do anything, but it seems like it's happening more and more and more across the United States where children and babies are losing their lives in increasing numbers at the hands of a mother or a father or, you know, someone that's really close to them. We don't really know too much of the details surrounding what happened to this child. But someone is facing charges there, you know, they have this person that's facing charges and everything, but it's just like, you know, what's really going on? And I agree, the neighbors in the community say they believe that there is, you know, some more to the story. And I mean, you know, had this baby been abused before, you know, is there a history of, you know, something going on with the mother there, or, you know, the people that are involved, like what's the backstory, you know, what's going on with that? It's just really crazy to me that it seems like we're losing our future. You know what I'm saying? It's like at the rate that we're going, we're not gonna have any children to, you know, take over and lead and do things to be able to grow up and live fulfilling lives and have families of their own and do things because they're being taken out day in and day out. There was recently a school shooting in Nashville. Nashville is probably like maybe 3 hours from here, where, you know, 3 9-year-olds lost their lives. It's like you just don't know from day to day what you can wake up to and what you're gonna find. It's really sad. It's really heartbreaking. This baby's 4 months old, and I'm not being judgmental, but I mean, from this picture, the mugshot, I don't know. There's some suspicious stuff going on here. And I'll definitely be back to follow up, you know, on this. Germantown, that suburb, it's considered to be kind of quiet, like nothing. I'm not gonna say nothing happens there, and maybe things that just ain't being reported, but you don't really hear about a lot of, you know, stuff going on in Germantown like you do, you know, in Memphis or North Memphis, South Memphis, or, you know, places like that. It's you know, considered to be like a quiet suburb, so you don't really hear too much going on. So, you know, for that to go on, I think, like they said, the neighbors were, you know, shocked. Not to say that violence isn't everywhere and crime isn't everywhere, because it definitely is, but it's just like in certain areas, you don't really hear too much about things that are going on. Like I said, not to say that things aren't, but there are just certain areas where either you don't hear about it or they don't report it. You know what I'm saying? So when you do hear news coming out of a specific area, it's just like, oh my God, you know what I'm saying? But I hate that for that baby. And just like the worker said, or social work, I'm not sure what she really was, but you really have to be vigilant. You know what I'm saying? If you see some crazy stuff going on, if I know people don't want to get involved in other people's business or other people's lives or whatever, but I mean, what chance do these children have these days? You know what I'm saying? If their own family won't protect them, you know, is there anybody out here who can or who will, who can step up? Or I wonder if anyone has seen anything, or if there's been any reports from that home before, you know, or anything like that. But I'll definitely be following up on that story. I just want to get on here and share really quickly about this. And I thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Thanks.